Hello students, in this session we will try to learn the digital signature and zero knowledge proofs. So these are the topics related to the security of the blockchain in the blockchain technology. So the digital signature is the extension of public key cryptography, the topic that we have studied in the previous session. So digital signature is equivalent to handwritten signature, but it is more secure than the handwritten signature. Handwritten signature can be faked, but it is not possible to fake the digital signature. So in blockchain we know the significance of this digital signature. Whenever any user wants to initiate the transaction, then that transaction is signed by the private key, and the receiver nodes in the blockchain can use the public key to verify that the message was created by the original sender. In the different stages in smart contracts, consensus mechanism, these digital signatures are used in blockchain environment. So digital signature has some properties. That properties are authentication, non-repudiation and integrity. And the first property of the digital signature is that authentication. It means that the message was created by the known sender. The digital signature gives us guarantee that the message was created by the known sender. Then second property of the digital signature is non-repudiation, and this property gives guarantee that the sender cannot deny having sent the message. Sender cannot say that I have not signed this this document. Then third property of the digital signature is integrity. This digital signature also gives the guarantee that the message was not altered during the transmission. Attacker has not changed the contents of message. This is also the guarantee that this digital signature algorithm should give. So we will study this digital signature algorithms in detail. So you can see students, there are three components of digital signature model. First component is key generation algorithm, second component is signing algorithm, and third component of digital signature is verification algorithm. The first component, which is known as key generation algorithm, this component creates two keys, private key and public key. One key is used to sign the message, to sign the document, and this key is kept secret, and this key is called private key, and other key is made available to the public. This key is called public key, and this is used to validate whether the message has been signed by the sender with the corresponding private key, that we can verify with the receiver can verify with the public key that the message was received from the original sender. Then second component of digital signature algorithm is signing algorithm. This signing algorithm produces a signature on the input message. The signing algorithm will take two inputs, private key of the sender and message, and it will generate a signature, and that signature is attached with the document. Then third component is the verification algorithm. This algorithm takes a signature, a message and public key as input. It will take three inputs. This verification algorithm actually has two parts. We will see in the details. It will take the three inputs, a message, public key and signature, and it will validate signature using the public key and returns a boolean variable, that is signature is valid or invalid. So we will see in details with the figure. So dear students, you can see this digital signature model. In this, Bob wants some message to send to the Alice with the digital signature. Then Bob will sign the document with the digital signature. So in this model, you can see there is a message M and private key of the Bob, and there is a component digital signature generation algorithm. This algorithm will take two inputs, private key of the Bob and message M, and then it will generate the digital signature, Bob's digital signature. And you can see this signature is attached with the message, message M and a signature yes. Then this message will be broadcasted on the network to the Alice. Alice will receive the document that will be signed by the signature by Bob. Then there is a role of digital signature verification algorithm. This verification algorithm will take this document which is digitally signed by the Bob. Then it will use the verification algorithm and it will use the public key to decrypt the message to verify the signature. And this verification algorithm will return whether the signature is valid or not valid. So you can see students, there are two components at receiver side and at sender side. You can see the sender side model of digital signature. There is a message M, or you can say document M. That document M, on that document M, cryptographic hash function is applied. Hash function will calculate the hash value from the document. Then there is an encryption algorithm. This encryption algorithm will take private key of the Bob and hash value that is generated from the message. It will encrypt that hash value and private key, and it will generate a document with digital signature. That document is then broadcasted to the Alice. Document is sent to the Alice on the network. Alice will receive the message M, digitally signed by the Bob. Then you can see this verification algorithm has two parts. You can see first part, message M. From message M, the Alice will apply the cryptographic hash function, and it will generate the hash value from the data from the message. Then you can see the second part of this verification algorithm. In that, there is a document, our document has the digital signature. So this algorithm will take the signature from the document and public key of the Bob. This public key is provided by the Bob, and this decryption algorithm will use the original hash algorithm, and it will generate the hash H dash. The first hash value is generated from the message, and second hash value is generated by the from the digital signature and public key of the Bob. If the both hash values H and H dash will match, that means the signature is valid. And if H and H dash doesn't match, that means signature is invalid. Then you can see students, what will happen at the sender side or signer side, the person who will sign the document digitally. So on sender side, the first step is to generate the hash of the data. Signer, the sender feeds the data to the hash function, and it will generate the hash of the data. Sender will generate the hash value from the data, and the value of this hash is unique to the data. Then it has to produce the digital signature. For digital signature, it will take this hash value and private key. And then this hash value and private key are then given to the signature algorithm, which produces the digital signature on a given hash. And this digital signature is attached to the document. Data is also there, and digital signature is also there. And this document, which is digitally signed by the sender, the third step, to send the document to the recipient, to send the message to the recipient. The user then sends the data with the digital signature to the intended user. So you can see this in figure. same part that we have explained in the previous slide. There is a message M, then on this message M hash algorithm is applied. Hash algorithm will generate the hash value, and then from this hash value this digital signature algorithm has to generate the digital signature. For generating the digital signature, it will take the hash value, that value is generated from the data, and private key, and from private key and hash value it will generate the digital signature, and this digital signature is attached to the document. Then at receiver side, the receiver checks the hash value generated by the sender. We know that the receiver has two parts. First part, it will generate the hash value from the data, and second part of the receiver is it will generate the hash value from the signature and public key provided by the sender. So first part of the receiver side is the receiver checks the hash value generated by the sender. After receiving the data and signature on it, the receiver gives the sender's public key and digital signature into the verification algorithm. This algorithm generates a hash value as output. Then additionally, it will regenerate the hash value from the data, and it will match the hash value sent by the sender. Additionally, the receiver uses the same hash function and generates the hash value of the original data. If this freshly generated hash value matches with the hash value sent from the user, the hash value that we have generated from the digital signature and hash value generated from the data, if that both values match, that means the receiver gets the assurance that the digital signature is valid. So this is how the digital signature algorithm works at the receiver side. You can see students with this figure. Model is at the receiver side. So at receiver side, receiver will receive the message. Then receiver has two models, two components. First, to generate the hash value from the data, and second, it will generate the hash value from the digital signature. So you can see there is a original message. Then this message is signed message. This signed message, it will take the digital signature and public key provided by the sender, and then it will calculate the hash value. Then second part of the algorithm is it will generate the hash value from the message, and it will compare this both hash values generated from the digital signature and hash value generated from the data, and if that both values match, that means that the signature is valid. So there are different applications of digital signature in blockchain. In consensus mechanism, the leader uses the digital signature to collect the votes from the nodes to confirm the new blocks. For verification, in consensus mechanism, the leader uses this digital signature. Then digital signatures can be used as a legal binding. Signers use their private key to sign on the smart contract. So smart contract program can also use this digital signatures. Signers can use the private key to sign the smart contract, and thus the parties involved can present this digital signature to a third party as evidence. There are some applications that require multiple signs, multiple signatures used in exchange balance. In exchange wallet, joint signature, more than one person could access the wallet, and for verifying the persons, the digital signature can be used. So these are the different applications of this digital signature in blockchain. Then students, the last topic of this unit is zero knowledge proofs. This is very new concept. You try to understand this concept. This zero knowledge proofs are based on interaction between prover and verifier. For understanding this zero knowledge proof, we can take the general example. Suppose someone has to convince to some other persons, and for convincing other person it will interact with the person and it will try to convince it will try to convince without giving much more proofs. Without giving the proofs, the party will try to convert the other party, and then the party to whom the one party wants to convince, that party will ask for various challenges. It will ask for various other things. From that things, the party can believe that the person who is trying to convince is right or not. So such type of, there are two parties in the zero knowledge proof algorithm: prover and verifier. Very informally, we can say that zero knowledge proof protocols allows one party, usually called prover, to convince the another party, called verifier. That prover knows some facts, some facts, and without giving much more proofs, this prover will try to convince the verify without giving any information about his knowledge, secret, or proofs. So in this zero knowledge proofs, a verifier would not be able to know any information beyond that statement is true or false. So verifier don't have much more proofs, but depending on the interaction between prover and verifier, verifier may come to the conclusion whatever the prover is saying, it is right or not, whether it is true or false. So this zero knowledge proof algorithms are based on interactive proof systems, or you can say challenge response authentication. Verifier can give the several challenges. It can ask for more information, and from that information the verifier may come to the conclusion that whatever the prover is trying to say, it is true or not. So there are two parties in the zero knowledge proofs: prover and verifier. Verifier accepts or rejects the prover. Whatever the prover says, the verifier may accept or verify may reject. If verifier is convinced, then verifier may accept whatever the things are said by the prover. So this method is used in the zero knowledge proofs. These are the zero knowledge proofs are interactive proof protocols. In an interactive proof systems, there are two parties: prover, often called Peggy, and verifier. Prover knows some secret or knowledge or a fact about a specific subject, and it tries to convince to the verifier through the communication with him, and that he has the above knowledge. And for communication, there may be a several rounds of interaction. For example, both prover and verifier possess an input X. Both have the input X, and prover wants to convince to the verifier that X has certain property, X has certain value, and that prover knows how to prove that property. So communication start usually by a challenge of verification, and after giving the challenge, prover will reply with the information to the verification, and from that information, the verifier may get convinced on the value of X, or it may reject, or it may accept the value. So at the end of this communication, at the end of this interaction, verifier either accepts or rejects the prover's statement, or verifier may get convinced or may not get convinced. So zero knowledge proofs transfer between the prover and verifier. The verifier accepts or rejects the proofs after multiple challenges and responses. So this method is based on probabilistic proof protocol. This zero knowledge proofs method overcomes problems with the password based systems. So there are two properties of zero knowledge proofs: completeness and soundness. completeness property says that succeeds with high probability for a true assertion given an honest verifier and honest prover. If the verifier is honest and if prover is honest, then there is a high probability that whatever the prover will say, the verifier will agree on that things, verifier will accept. There is a little chance of rejecting the things proposed by the prover. So this is the first property of the zero knowledge proofs. Then second property of the zero knowledge proof is fails for any other false assertion given a dishonest prover and honest verifier. If dishonest prover tries to convince to the verifier, so this zero knowledge proof algorithms give guarantee that the honest verifier will not accept the things shared by the prover. So these are the two properties of this zero knowledge. Dear students, in this session we have studied the digital signatures and zero knowledge proofs. This is the end of unit 1 also. In we have completed the unit 1, and from next week we are going to start the unit 2. The things that I have explained in this session, I will try to explain in Marathi also for your better understanding. I will give the short explanation of the things that we have covered in this session. So in विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आपण या सेशन मध्ये दोन टॉपिकचा स्टडी केला, पब्लिक की क्रिप्टोग्राफी अँड नॉट पब्लिक की क्रिप्टोग्राफी. वी हॅव स्टडीड द डिजिटल सिग्नेचर्स आणि झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफ्स. सो डिजिटल सिग्नेचर हे जे आहेत, जे आपण जो मागचा सेशनमध्ये जो आपण टॉपिक स्टडी केला, त्याचाच हा पुढचा पार्ट आहे डिजिटल सिग्नेचर. पब्लिक की क्रिप्टोग्राफीचा वापर आपण डिजिटल सिग्नेचरसाठी करू शकतो. डिजिटल सिग्नेचर्स ह्या मोर जास्त सुरक्षित आहेत याच्यापेक्षा, जे डॉक्युमेंट आपण हँड हाताने साईन करतो त्याच्यापेक्षा जास्त सुरक्षित आहेत. कारण हाताने साईन केलेल्या जे सिग्नेचर्स आहेत त्या पुन्हा तशाच पद्धतीने रिप्रोड्यूस केल्या जाऊ शकतात, पण डिजिटल सिग्नेचरमध्ये ते शक्य नाही. तर डिजिटल सिग्नेचरमध्ये तुम्ही जर दोन पार्टीज असतात, सेंडर आणि रिसिव्हर. सेंडर जो आहे तो कुठलं तरी डॉक्युमेंट साईन करून रिसिव्हरला पाठवतो. सेंडर साईडला डॉक्युमेंट असतं, त्या डॉक्युमेंटपासून हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट केली जाते, आणि हॅश व्हॅल्यू जी जनरेट केली आहे डॉक्युमेंटपासून, त्या हॅश व्हॅल्यूबरोबर प्रायव्हेट की, जी सेंडरची प्रायव्हेट की आहे, ती प्रायव्हेट की वापरून डिजिटल सिग्नेचर जनरेट केले जाते. आणि ती डिजिटल सिग्नेचर आपण डॉक्युमेंटला अटॅच करतो, आणि त्या डॉक्युमेंटमध्ये ओरिजिनल मेसेज तर असतोच, त्याच्याबरोबर डिजिटल सिग्नेचर अटॅच केलेली असते. मग हे जे डॉक्युमेंट डिजिटली साईन केलेलं आहे, हे नेटवर्कवरून रिसिव्हरला पाठवलं जातं. रिसिव्हर साईडला दोन मॉडेल असतात, एक मॉडेल जो हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट करतो फ्रॉम डिजिटल सिग्नेचरपासून, आणि दुसरं मॉडेल जे डेटा असतो, मेसेज असतो, त्याच्यापासून हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट करतो. आणि या दोघं ज्या हॅश व्हॅल्यू आहे त्यांचं कंपॅरिझन केलं जातं. त्या जर बरोबर असतील, त्या मॅच होत असतील, तर सिग्नेचर व्हॅलिड आहे, याचा अर्थ असा होतो. तर जो पहिला कंपोनंट आहे त्याच्यात जे डॉक्युमेंटमध्ये सिग्नेचर आहे, ती सिग्नेचर घेऊन आणि पब्लिक की जी सेंडरने प्रोव्हाइड केली आहे, या पब्लिक कीचा वापर करून हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट केली जाते. देन मेसेजमध्ये जो डेटा आहे, तो डेटा घेऊन ओरिजिनल अल्गोरिदम जो एन्क्रिप्शनसाठी वापरला होता, जो सेंडरने वापरला होता हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट करण्यासाठी, तो अल्गोरिदम घेऊन ओरिजिनल मेसेजपासून, ओरिजिनल डेटापासून आपण हॅश व्हॅल्यू जनरेट करतो. देन सिग्नेचरपासून जनरेट झालेली हॅश व्हॅल्यू आणि डेटापासून जनरेट झालेली हॅश व्हॅल्यू हे कम्पेअर केले जातात, आणि दोघं मॅच असेल तर सिग्नेचर व्हॅलिड असते. ब्लॉकचेनमध्ये वेगवेगळ्या स्टेजवर डिजिटल सिग्नेचरचा वापर केला जातो, आपल्याला माहिती आहे. सेंडर जेव्हा कुठलाही नोड जेव्हा ट्रान्झॅक्शन इनिशिएट करतो, स्टार्ट करतो, त्यावेळेला ते ट्रान्झॅक्शन डिजिटल सिग्नेचरने, प्रायव्हेट कीने साईन केलं जातं. आणि जे नोड्स आहेत ब्लॉकचेनमध्ये, ते नोड्स पब्लिक की वापरून ते ट्रान्झॅक्शन व्हेरिफिकेशन करू शकतात. कन्सेन्सस अल्गोरिदम, स्मार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, देन मल्टीपल सिग्नेचर, असे वेगवेगळे ॲप्लिकेशन डिजिटल सिग्नेचरचे ब्लॉकचेन्समध्ये आहेत. देन जो दुसरा पार्ट आहे तो थोडा आपल्याला सगळ्यांना कन्फ्यूज करू शकतो, झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफ्स. याबद्दल थोडंसं आपण मराठीत समजून घेण्याचा प्रयत्न केला. झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफमध्ये काय असतं की एखादा माणूस दुसऱ्या माणसाला खूप जास्त प्रूफ न देता एखाद्या गोष्टीवर ॲग्री होण्यासाठी सांगतो. तो मग ते तो जो समोरचा माणूस आहे तो ॲग्री केव्हा होईल त्यासाठी दोघांमध्ये कम्युनिकेशन होतं, इंटरॅक्शन होतं, आणि ज्याला आपल्याला कन्व्हिन्स करायचं आहे तो माणूस जो आहे तो मग वेगवेगळे प्रश्न विचारून आपलं कन्फर्मेशन करून घेतो की समोरचा माणूस जे सांगतो आहे ते बरोबर आहे का नाही. तर झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफमध्ये दोन एंटिटी असतात, एक प्रूवर आणि एक व्हेरीफायर. प्रूवर जो आहे, समजा व्हॅल्यू एक्स असेल तर एक्सची जर काही एक्स एक्स इनपुट दिलं आणि त्याची काही व्हॅल्यू असेल, त्याची काही प्रॉपर्टी असेल, तर प्रूवर व्हेरीफायरला ही प्रॉपर्टी या एक्स व्हॅल्यूची अशी आहे असं सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न करतो. आणि त्यानंतर जो व्हेरीफायर आहे तो मग वेगवेगळे प्रश्न विचारून कन्फर्मेशन करून घेतो आणि मग तो ॲक्सेप्ट करतो किंवा रिजेक्ट करतो, तो ॲग्री होतो किंवा ॲग्री होत नाही. अशा प्रकारचा हा झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफ्स आहे. याच्यामध्ये खूप जास्त काही पुरावे दिले जात नाही, फक्त याच्यामध्ये इंट्रॅक्शन होतं, कन्व्हिन्स केलं जातं. आणि जर समोरचा माणूस कन्व्हिन्स झाला तर मग तो ॲक्सेप्ट करतो किंवा रिजेक्ट करतो. सो अशा प्रकारच्या जनरल जी थेअरी आहे जी दोन माणसांच्या याच्यामध्ये कम्युनिकेशनमध्ये होते त्या थेअरीचा वापर या झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफमध्ये केलेला आहे. जसं आपण एखादी गोष्ट कोणाला तरी सिक्रेट गोष्ट सांगतो परंतु आपल्याकडे फारसे पुरावे नसतात त्या गोष्टीचे, मग तो माणूस जो असतो ज्याला आपण ती सांगतो तो वेगवेगळ्या माध्यमातून आपल्याकडून ते हे करून घेतो की जाणून घेतो की हे खरं आहे का नाही. आणि त्याला जर वाटलं की हा माणूस खरं सांगतोय तर तो मग ती गोष्ट ॲक्सेप्ट करतो किंवा रिजेक्ट करतो. अशा प्रकारचा जो बेसिक हे आहे फंडा या झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफमध्ये यूज केला आहे. तर झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफ जे आहेत ते ब्लॉकचेनमध्ये वापरले जातात. काही झेडकॅस, झेडकॅसचं नावच झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफवरून आलेलं आहे. झेडकॅसमध्ये झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफचा हे वापरला जातो अल्गोरिदम. नंतर झेड कॉईन, झेड कॉईनसुद्धा झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफवरून या झेड कॉईनचं नाव निघालेलं आहे. तर झेड कॉईनमध्ये पण या झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफचा अल्गोरिदम हा कन्व्हिन्सिंग अल्गोरिदम आहे. हा दोन लोकांच्या संवादावर अवलंबून आहे आणि संवादामध्ये जर सांगणारा माणूस प्रामाणिक असेल आणि ऐकणारा पण प्रामाणिक असेल तर जो काही सांगेल प्रूवर त्याच्यावर वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे चॅलेंज देऊन नंतर वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारची माहिती जाणून घेऊन आणि मग प्रूवर कन्व्हिन्स होतो की जे सांगतो आहे ते समोरचा माणूस खरं आहे. या झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफमध्ये जर रिसीव प्रूवर आणि व्हेरीफायर हे प्रामाणिक असतील तर गॅरंटी असते याच्यामध्ये की जे काय सांगितलं जातं आहे ते ॲक्सेप्ट होईल. जर प्रूवर डिसऑनेस्ट असेल म्हणजे तो प्रामाणिक नसेल तर त्यावेळेला मात्र ही झिरो नॉलेज प्रूफ सिस्टमची अशी हे असली पाहिजे, अल्गोरिदम असा असला पाहिजे की त्याने ते रिजेक्ट केलं पाहिजे. जर जो माणूस प्रामाणिक नाही असं जर कोणीतरी एंटिटी सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न करत आहे तर त्या याने व्हेरीफायरने ते रिजेक्ट केलं पाहिजे. अशा पद्धतीने अल्गोरिदम डिझाईन केले. तर विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आपण इथे पहिल्या युनिटचा आपला सिलेबस पूर्ण झालेला आहे आणि पुढच्या आठवड्यापासून आपण आता दुसऱ्या युनिटला आपण सुरुवात करू. दुसरा युनिट ज्यामध्ये संपूर्ण ब्लॉकचेन बिटकॉईनचा सिलेबस आहे, बिटकॉईनचे डिटेल्स आपल्याला, बिटकॉईनमध्ये ट्रान्झॅक्शन काय होते, बिटकॉईनमध्ये सिक्युरिटी मेकॅनिझम काय आहे, जे पूर्ण युनिट जे आहे दुसरं युनिट ते बिटकॉईनला डेडिकेटेड केलेले आहे. तर पुढच्या वीकमध्ये आपण बिटकॉईनचा स्टडी करू. धन्यवाद विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो.